majesty. Worship his majesty. Unto Jesus be all glory, power.
Well, we're very, very privileged and happy to have Brother Daniel with us today.
Different from your trouble. We don't have to deal with a white or black man. dissimilar trouble than you experience. Because we deal with the people who know that there is God. So we start right away from the known God to the unknown Jesus. It is not as hard as your task. I remember when I was saved in Kimberley, there was a Scotchman. I still know his name, you know, that was way back in 1929. His name was Mr. Ware, W-E-I-R. He was a Scotchman. He didn't believe in the existence of God. When I tried to testify, he was very fond of me. But after I was saved, he was just a next-door neighbor to the company for which I worked. And he thought I was a fool. There is no God. I said, who made me? He said, my father made me. So that was my first experience. When I went overseas, I found that is a great deal of trouble, especially in England, apart from all other countries. We meet it in many countries, but it has been well known in England, where people are highly sophisticated. It's a blessing to live with Englishmen. If you want to learn, be an educated man, and know something, you go to England. It's an old country, and they have everything. To know the very first man who brought Christianity into England about the 4th or 5th century, you know that these people are old. They were not born yesterday. I went to Westminster Abbey and went to St. Paul's Cathedral and saw cloisters which the modern builders cannot do today. They were made by people with their hands. And they're wonderful. If I would want modern people to do something like those cloisters, they would be able to do it. They were done by men. It took years for them to do those things. So when you come to England, you begin to learn afresh that an Englishman is not a man born yesterday. But if you look at him, he looks like another white man. There's no difference, but you know, there is something here in his head. Now, talking about the people, as we always say, people have got many notions. Somebody wrote a book that man's enemy is himself. We have got enemies from outside, but my worst enemy is myself. That's my worst foe. He argues with me, he dictates to me, this man whose name is I. He directs me, he leads me away from God's will. He makes me read books, he makes me meet people, he makes me think I'm being pragmatic, he makes me think that I am able to think, I'm given by God a mind.